Another revised kit on the bench, this 77 Ford delivery van from AMT. Now, you've seen me build this van up as the 77 cruising van, and I will link in the description the build of that one so you can see how the van itself is going to go together. What we're going to do on this one is a little bit of an abbreviated review since I've built this kit in its entirety before. We're going to show you everything in the box and what's new, what's revised about this kit for this release. So let's move that beautiful Coke box back there. First off, we're gonna have the cab and the interior pieces. As you can see, those are still the same from the other release. They got the doghouse in the center. They got the nice ribbed cargo detail. That looks awesome on there. We've got the white body here. Now, of course, you can do this up in Coca-Cola livery. You can do it up as any other kind of van you want. It's your model. You're just buying it to get it, and if you want to do it up with a Coke delivery theme or whatnot, that is completely up to you. Nothing is required. You can see this one's got the back window glass open there. We've got our wheel backs on that tree. On this one, we've got our nice V8. Should you have a V8? No, you should have a Coke. Manifold, heads, various other engine parts like the oil pan, water pump system. What else we got over here? I love the sound of that plastic when it's new. We got a nice spare tire cover carrier with ribs in it. We got a CB radio. We got the luggage rack on the top. We got some what looks like antennas and other accessories on there. On this tree, we've got our beautiful Ford dashboard. Well done. Radiator firewall system. This one does have an opening hood, so you will be able to see the engine details. Differential, rear suspension, front I-beam suspension, shocks, and different radius arms for the suspension. Nice looking on there. This tree here has ribs for the frame or the body and our full exhaust system. Work truck would just have a basic exhaust. We got the nice one-piece frame. I love that. All nice and straight, no issues with that, no issues with the cruising van build either. They're taking care of those molds, and you can see these things aren't dripping with flash, so even the flash whiners aren't going to have a hard time with it. We got the nice utility seats. We've got different under-engine accessories. Looks like a fuel tank. We got the nice hood there. The Ford emblem is prominent and easy to paint. Our nice steering wheel and our wheel backs on the chrome tree. We've got one set of wheel options molded open very nicely. We've got our grill, bumpers, and small accessories like the mirrors. That's the styrene in the kit so far, but we're not done. We've got stuff on the other side of the table to look at. This thing is packed super full of parts. We've got some new parts. That's why I wanted to take them out of the plastic. You're spotting them as they come out on the table. In the bag over here, we've got our two door glass. You can leave them in or out. And we've got the back glass, and we've got the windshield. Do with those what you will, but those are nice, beautiful, standard clear pieces. We'll leave them in there so they don't get scratched. We've got some red line tires. There is no name on those, just the red line stripe to match with the red Coke theme. Or flip them over to the other side. You have some very nice black wall tires for your delivery truck. Excellent tread pattern. Four of those, they're hollow, so they will press over pre-assembled wheels. We do have optional cruising windows for the back of the van. You can cut those out, or you could tint them and place them so they stick out prominently. Those always look nice. On the cruising van, I use the decals. We got our red taillights. Those work out better than trying to do it yourself. We've got clear glass. This is for the vending machine. You can see how it's got raised detail, so you can present that like they always did with the lighted glass window on the vending machine, and then your soda descriptions behind it, and then your coin slot and money changer right there. That is a new piece for this kit. We've got two Coke bottle racks. All right. All you have to do, they're molded in that Coke bottle color, is paint around the bases, and you are all set to go with awesome two cases of Coca-Cola and a 70s-style Coca-Cola vending machine. We've seen the 50s-style and the die-cast that they have. This one is bigger, of course. It's in two pieces to make painting and detailing easier. Goes together. We can see it's got a wood grain down here. It's got our can drop our coin slots. We're going to paint this up and work on it. We're going to build this and the racks of Coca-Cola bottles for the review so that we can take a look at the new parts and what you can get for it. Last but not least, the gigantic Coca-Cola decal sheet. This thing is huge. Look at that, big sheet. There we are for the vending machine. We've got Orange Shock Soda, Goofy Grape, Fizzy Up, and Coca-Cola on there. We've got our coin slots, Coca-Cola emblems. Here's the one that goes behind the glass window. Then we've got different color Coke emblems for those Coke bottles, or even just the names. We've got I'd Like to Buy the World of Coke in white and red. We've got a gajillion license plates. This one makes me giggle, Coke Van. That'll get you pulled over every day. And we've got some other logos here. It's the real thing, Coke slogans, and giant logos for the van or any other vehicle you build. Really nice decal sheets. So what I'm going to do is we've already seen the build of the cruising van, and I will link that below so you can see the van go together. I'm going to work on the soda machine and the soda bottles, and this will be a quick review to see how those come out, the new parts in the kit. Thank you. Now we'll take a look at AMT's reissued 125th scale holiday van, the Fruehauf box trailer from AMT. It's in 125th scale. It's got some options on this one we haven't seen on some other trailers we built. This one's got two position trailer jacks. You can select a point on your tandem sliding suspension. It's over 19 inches long and is done up in the Coca-Cola motif, which makes it perfect for a show off with the delivery van. Let's get a bunch of plastic out here. Now, a lot of these kits, what I'm gonna start doing if I don't have a chance to build them, we're still gonna take a look, let you see what's out and what's in the box. That will mean that every kit that comes in does get a show, so you can see what's going on. We've got this nice decal cutting template. Let you do that. We'll see that in the decals in a moment, don't worry. We've got our trailer tandem axle supports here where you can slide them back and forth. We've got our springs. So much plastic in this one. We got our trailer jacks. The other one fell off the tree. It is identical mirror image of that. We've got our wheels, our wheel backs. We've got suspension components, braces. Excellent molding. I'm not seeing a gajillion piles of flash on this. We've got some axle supports here. Check those out. Nice I-beam detail on that. Again, not seeing a lot of flash. Nothing to worry about. These are well maintained. These have been reissued a few times. We got some gorgeous mud flaps with the Fruehauf emblems on them. And on this one, we've got our wheel faces and other trailer parts. Take a look. I like how they're molded open. I always love that. We got a chrome tree here with some brake components, trim rings, reflectors for the lights. We got our jack handle and the nice trim rings on there. Beautiful molded in chrome. If you're doing it up as the holiday trailer, you know, you're gonna make it a little extra flashy. Coca-Cola would have really spent some time decking out those trailers. We also have some nice, super flexible vinyl tubing. We've seen this in other reviews, like my garage jack review, the lift review. The new tubing they're putting in here is super flexible. It's not the old stiff vinyl tubing. And we've got some clear red, clear yellow lights for our trailer markings. We're not even close to done. The box is completely full of awesome stuff. Goodyear branded tires. Always love when they put branded tires. These have the logos and everything. Call outs, pressures all around the outside. Printed on both sides, and an excellent tread pattern that's not too shallow so that it looks good. Of course, you're going to get 8 of those. There is no spare underneath this one that I've seen. Let's get out a couple pounds worth of plastic. More plastic here than they have oil in Iraq. Gorgeous beaded texture, molded extremely finely. Nice thick sides so you can glue things together. I love the tabs on there. Makes everything easy to put together and interlock. You're not wishing and hoping and praying. We've got our doors here. This one has opening doors. You can build them as opening doors and decorate the interior of the trailer. There's where our hitch mounts, our kingpin mounts. Nice looking. We've got our corrugated sides. Excellent texture on those. Marker light locations. We've even got vertical body ribbing on there where they put the panels together and riveted them together. There's our attachment hinges for our doors on the back. And on this one as well, everything interlocks and pushes together with a little tab and lock system. So that makes things real nice when assembling. Of course, you'll get 2 of those side panels. They are mirror images of each other. We've got the roof of the trailer here, one long seamless part. And then the bottom is ribbed so that when you look inside the trailer, it does look appropriate. Since this one has open doors, you'd want to see those braces across that roof. And then we have the trailer floor with all of its appropriate bracing. Location mounts for the axles and whatnot so you can center them correctly. And on this one, if we can get the camera to focus on the white, wood grain boards going all different directions on the interior of the trailer. So when you open it up, you can see that texture. We're not done. Let's go to the other side of the table, see what else is in the box. Well, what else is in the box is this gorgeous set of decals. Oh, you get 2 like that. We'll take a look at that in a second. We get the massive Santa Claus Coca-Cola emblems, the huge white Coca-Cola emblems for the side of the trailer. We've got all of our numbering still on there, license plates, serial numbers, all that's still on there, with the added bonus of literally like $30 or more worth of Coca-Cola water slide decals. This is a double sheet. You get two of these. Is that not the most gorgeous thing? Oh, that is so pretty. We've got our warning tape. We've got our licenses. We've got our call outs. We've got some American flags on there, Fruehauf labels, and you'll get two of those identical sheets in this kit. It's just absolutely outstanding what they put in this version. So you can build your own box trailer, or you can build the Coca-Cola holiday van, and that's what makes it so special. So that's everything that's in that box, and thanks for watching the workshop. Another fun quick set of review done on the workshop. The reason I'm just showing you the parts on that, one, I've built this one. Two, I wanted to match it up with the other Coca-Cola release recently of that holiday van. I build over 100 model kits for the show every single year, and I don't have time to build every single new release, but I want to do these short videos coming out in between all the full releases and the full builds to show you the awesome stuff that's being released by model companies this year. Everything that's new coming out, everything they send, I want to make sure it gets on the show. And with something like this, these new Coca-Cola vending machines, we've seen the smaller die-cast ones included in numerous kits. This all-new one with the bottles and everything, this is a new thing for AMT with their Coca-Cola kits. And I want to make sure that you had an excellent look at it, because look at that. That thing is fantastic. Looks every bit of scale, and it's really going to help the diorama builders. You can do it in different color schemes, how the other machines came. This is, I choose to build it as it was shown on the box art. I like that way, and it comes out absolutely awesome. Do not forget, in that van kit, with the vending machine and the Coke bottles, you're still going to be left with a huge assortment of decals that I didn't use for different labeling, all different kinds of logos and accents that we went over, and license plates, and a whole bunch of drink left over for the vending machine. Excellent little mini kits in there that look fantastic with just a couple hours worth of paintwork on them. Go ahead. These kits are out right now. I will link in the description where these are available to be purchased, and we will see you at the next review.